To simplify this expression, we have to apply power rule. Okay, I'm gonna write down power rule again. So if we have something like this, a to the power of x outside the whole thing to the power of y, guys, we know what? We know that when you have exponent right next to each other, what can you do? You can just put them together, right? You can just put them together like this. So basically you multiply the exponent together. Okay, so guys, that's what we're gonna do here, okay? So the question we have, 3, we also have a to the power of 4. On the bottom we have 5. We also have b to the power of 10. And we also have c to the power of 7. Okay, so guys, and question says, we want the whole thing to the power of 2. Okay? So what we can do is what? We can bring the exponent to everyone. So let's bring the exponent to 3 first. Okay? So I'm going to put it right here. And guys, now let's bring the exponent to the second guy right here. Okay? Oops. So let's bring the exponent to the second guy right here. Okay, so let's bring the exponent 2 to the second guy, a to the power of 4. Okay? So guys, look at this. Exponent, we can just put them together, right? So let's bring the 2 right next to 4, right here. Do you see that? Exponent, let's just put them together. Okay, now we're ready to bring the exponent to the bottom. So let's bring the exponent to the 5. Mm-hmm. And let's bring the exponent 2 to b to the power of 10. Right here, you see that? Exponent, we put them together. Okay, same as this. So bring the exponent 2 to the last guy right here. You see that? So what we just did was what? We brought the exponent 2 to everybody. Right? Mm-hmm, like this. Bring the exponent 2 to everybody. Okay, so now we're ready to get the final answer. So the final answer we have, guys, 3 squared, we have 9. Okay? And guys, now a to the power of what? 4 times 2 is 8. Okay, so the numerator is done. Let's look at the denominator. We have 5 squared, which is 25. Okay, we have b to the power of 10 times 2, so that's b to the power of 20. Okay, now the last guy right here. C to the power of 7 times 2, which is 14. So c to the power of 14. And that is the final answer. To simplify this expression, we have to apply power rule. Okay, I'm gonna write down power rule again. So if we have something like this, a to the power of x outside the whole thing to the power of y, guys, we know what? We know that when you have exponent right next to each other, what can you do? You can just put them together, right? You can just put them together like this. So basically you multiply the exponent together. Okay, so guys, that's what we're gonna do here, okay? So the question we have, 3, we also have a to the power of 4. On the bottom we have 5. We also have b to the power of 10. And we also have c to the power of 7. Okay, so guys, and question says, we want the whole thing to the power of 2, okay? So what we can do is what? We can bring the exponent to everyone. So let's bring the exponent to 3 first, okay? So I'm going to put it right here. And guys, now let's bring the exponent to the second guy right here, okay? Oops. So let's bring the exponent to the second guy right here. Okay, so let's bring the exponent 2 to the second guy, a to the power of 4. Okay? So guys, look at this. Exponent, we can just put them together, right? So let's bring the 2 right next to 4. right here. Do you see that? Exponent, exponent. Let's just put them together. Okay, now we're ready to bring the exponent to the bottom. So let's bring the exponent to the 5. Mm-hmm. And let's bring the exponent 2 to b to the power of 10. Right here. You see that? Exponent, exponent. Exponent, exponent. We put them together. Okay, same as this. So bring the exponent 2 to the last guy right here. You see that? So what we just did was what? We brought the exponent 2 to everybody. Right? Mm-hmm. Like this. Bring the exponent 2 to everybody. Okay? So now we're ready to get the final answer. So the final answer we have, guys, 3 squared, we have 9. Okay? And guys, now A to the power of what? 4 times 2 is 8. Okay, so the numerator is done. Let's look at the denominator. We have 5 squared, which is 25. Okay, we have b to the power of 10 times 2. So that's b to the power of 20. Okay, now the last guy right here. C to the power of 7 times 2, which is 14. So c to the power of 14. And that is the final answer.